Hey guys, this is MJ from thetoneking.com, and you're watching a special edition of On the Mark. Here we are, day one of building the pedal. Bought myself a soldering iron at the local hardware store. We're gonna see how this works out. Keep in mind when you're building your Mod Kits DIY Trill Tremolo pedal, you're gonna need a few things. Wire strippers, needle nose pliers, cutting pliers, desoldering pump, solder, 64 resin core, soldering station, Phillips head screwdrivers, slotted tip screwdrivers, 3mm tip, channel lock pliers, ruler, and a hobby vise, or something to hold on to the box while you're working. Keep in mind, building this pedal is a 6-hour project, so if you're planning to finish it all in one night, you're going to have to pull a marathon. I suggest building it in 3 separate days. That'll give you more time to really worry about every little piece that you have to put together. Welcome to day 2 of the amazing pedal building adventure. I am your host, Mark Johnson. Frustrated host, I might add. I'm frustrated because I bought a really, really crappy soldering gun. This thing right here. And this is garbage. You might be able to do some craft work or something like this, but this is not the type of gun that you want to use when you're putting together a pedal or any type of circuit equipment. I have this new soldering gun, thanks to a friend of mine named Jimmy, and he's a good friend because without him I would be going insane right now. With deadlines approaching and me having to finish a pedal, it does not make it easy when your soldering gun does not work.
So, believe it or not, once I got the soldering gun, building this thing became really fun. I couldn't believe how easily I was moving through most of this stuff. The directions were simple to follow, and I was able to make most of my connections without any issues. At this point in the process, it would have actually been a better idea had I read the instructions completely through before I started. They specify exactly how long each wire should be cut and how much should be stripped off of each end. But of course, I, you know, being the anxious, impatient individual that I am, just went straight ahead into it. In spite of my inability to read through directions, I was lucky enough to be able to pull off all the wiring without a hitch. This is the point where everything got really, really fun.
Now we're running on day 3 of putting this pedal together. So far it's been pretty cool. Had a few setbacks to begin with, but now that I've finally gotten myself a decent solder gun, and now that I have actually learned how to solder correctly and paid more careful attention to the instructions, I have been able to actually make some decent headway, and I think I'm almost done. The one thing, I am scared to death of whatever the hell these things are, because they came wrapped in this little paper thing, and it makes me think that they are very, very important. Plus, there's only 3 of them. So, I'm going to try not to screw these up and continue working.
I think I spent the most time working on this than the third day. It was by this time that I got really, really excited, and I was really stoked to hear what this thing was going to sound like once I finished it. So I just kept working. Thank you. Although I had some problems in the beginning because I didn't have the right tools for the job, once I plugged this thing in, I realized it was all worth it. The only things I really suggest to everybody is to make sure that you follow three simple rules. Make sure you have the right tools, read the directions, and lay out all of your parts before you start building. If you follow those rules, you should have a great time building it, and you'll end up with a pretty cool pedal at the end. Make sure you stay tuned to thetoneking.com all through November for more from 30 Pedals in 30 Days, and I'll see you next time on The Mark.